It was one of the great migrations of human history. For thousands of years, millions of people left their homes and villages in mainland China to find refuge, a better life, and eventually prosperity in the vast watery world of Southeast Asia.
南洋华人是包容多种文化的一个载体。他们有他们的想法，跟中国就不同。
They endured catastrophes, both natural and man-made. They founded communities and even new cities.
我们死都不怕，所以我们呢就这样回来的。They
became entrepreneurs and revolutionaries, artists and philanthropists.
Every flower has its own beauty. And if you put those flowers together, they become more beautiful.
But they endured to transform the new world they came to. For millennia, many hundreds of thousands of Chinese wanderers have come to the Southern Ocean as explorers, travelers, conquerors, traders, and refugees. They called this part of the world the Nanyang. The Chinese fled war, poverty, and political repression. They first came here in the wake of Austronesian-speaking peoples like the Malays and made Southeast Asia a new frontier of Imperial China.
But the reason why they went to Southeast Asia is very clear. There was a better future awaiting them. At least that is what they were expecting. On the other hand, from the 1850s, 1860s onwards, there was a very large migration of Chinese workers who went to Southeast Asia to work on the plantations. Those people went there under very bad conditions, but they still went there because they were hungry at home, they had nothing to eat, and because they were expecting to make a lot of money while in Southeast Asia. And that actually also happened, otherwise it would have come to a stop.
从这个长安跟这个丝绸之路那个时候已经发达了，其实南边也有个丝绸之路，但南边的丝绸之路完全是靠海洋外国的商船到中国来做生意的。19世纪，现在南洋的华人，他们主要的原因是有两个，有两种，一个是内因，一个是外因。从中国的观点来看，就是因为当时 人口众多了，政治动乱了，贫穷与饥饿，都促使沿海一带的华人离乡背井，要寻找更美好的生活。来到了东南亚的那些殖民主义者，因为要开发东南亚，需要大量的人力，就从外头引进了
This epic migration left traces in every region of Southeast Asia. August 31st, 2012, all over Southeast Asia, in Malaysia, the Philippines, and across Indonesia, tens of thousands of people of Chinese descent celebrate the Hungry Ghost Festival. This is Penang in modern Malaysia. But the modern Hungry Ghost Festival is a portal to a Chinese past, a living, vibrant time machine. Today, ghosts and spirits of the ancestors will join together with the living. The festival is all about paying respects to one's forebears, joining the continuum of life over centuries of Chinese history. Incense is burned, offerings are made to the ghosts, whose presence is shown by empty chairs. Today in Malaysia, the Chinese past comes alive in the present. These Chinese Malaysians celebrating the Hungry Ghost Festival today think back over their lives of their illustrious forebears who set off on perilous journeys from the motherland. They reflect on what they endured and achieved, what they left behind.
这种传统也是一种文化来的。你看，它槟城现在大街小巷都在进行这种民间的这种祭拜，所以这些等等都是跟我们华族文化很深的关系。For
the hundreds of Chinese generations who came here to the world south of the ocean have epic tales to tell, stories of blood and violence that drove millions to search for new homes in a faraway place. Here is just one story of many, a tale of slaughter and desperate flight. According to ancient chronicles, in September 879 AD, a rebel force led by Wang Chao attacked the city of Guangzhou and slaughtered its people. It is estimated that the rebels murdered more than 120,000 people. Many were merchants with contacts all over the Southern Ocean. And it was to there that the survivors fled, taking with them their resilience and talents.
当时这个黄巢之乱，就黄巢打下长安之后，后来被这个北方的这军阀打败了，打败了之后他们就向南退，向南退的时候一部分到福建去。 黄巢自己就带了一部分到广州，到广州的时候呢，他就杀了许多这些商人，所以这阿拉伯的这些记录里头就说的，有多少万的阿拉伯商人在广州被杀，那么其他没被杀的就退到东南亚去。A
century after the catastrophe in Guangzhou, an Arabic traveler stumbled on a Chinese settlement in Palembang on the island of Sumatra. The people he met turned out to be the descendants of the desperate men and women who had escaped from Guangzhou, and they were already prospering. What China lost, Sumatra gained. And not only Sumatra.
王朝更替以后是败者逃亡，那么包括逃亡到海外，这是每个朝代基本上都会发生的，只是有些朝代规模比较大，有些朝代规模比较小。
In modern Southeast Asia, nearly 6.5 million Malaysians are of Chinese descent, as are more than 3.5 million Singaporeans, 1.5 million Filipinos, and 10 million Indonesians. China was a vast human pump that pushed its peoples across the southern oceans, and many Chinese were blessed with the maritime skills that made escape possible. Historians have now revealed that the Chinese have always been a great seafaring people.
唐朝、唐末、唐末分裂了嘛？五代之后呢，就有个南汉国，在广州，一个闽国，在福建，这些独立的小国家，那么他们就开始鼓励商人出海去跟这些外国人做事。当时我相信，当时有中国的船出去，不过可能还是少。 所以到郑和下西洋的时候呢，那不必说了，中国船不得了，全世界的船都没有中国的船那么好，那么坚那么大，装那么多人，装那么多货，不是突然来的，它有几百年的造船的经验。
It was diligent learning that would make the Chinese the most mobile people on earth.